Ever wonder how to create a user on a server? Wonder if you could do it across different versions the same way? Wonder what tools you can use? Well, guess what? I'm gonna tell you the answers to all those questions and show you the secrets that are gonna make it easy for you. All that and more coming up now. Hello, everybody. My name is Adam Gordon, entertainer here at IT Pro TV, coming at you with an episode about how to add a user to your Windows server. But guess what? We're going to do this a variety of ways, use a bunch of cool tools, and I'm going to let you in on a secret Microsoft doesn't often tell people. It's all the same. What do I mean by that? You running server 16? You may be running server 19. I'm guessing you're not running server 22 yet, although you probably want to be. Latest and greatest across all three of those versions of server, we're going to add a user using the same tools. It's going to look and feel the same. And by the way, it's going to be super easy. I'm going to show you how to do it on server 2019, but it's going to be the same if you did it on server 16 and or if you use the technical preview and or the latest version of server 2022 as it goes to market and ultimately is available. Join me here. We're going to run server 2019 as a virtual machine. You could see at the lower right-hand corner right here, I am running server 2019 data center evaluation edition. So we're running the latest current production build of that system. And I'm gonna use the same set of tools I would use if I did this on server 16 and or on server 2022. Now we're gonna do this three different ways for you. Three different versions of the operating system. We're gonna give you three tools and three options to do this. I'm gonna show you how to do it from the server manager via a tool called the computer management tool. This is a standalone server. It's not joined to a domain. So we're gonna administer it locally using our first option. And we're gonna use the computer management console to be able to use our local users and groups tool. And we're gonna simply add a user right from the graphical interface. Once we've done that, we'll take a look at PowerShell. We'll show you how to do the same thing from the command line. We'll add a couple of twists to give you a few options there, but essentially we'll do the same thing. And then I'm gonna use what I'll say is a new tool, new in the sense that it's been around less than the server manager, less time than some of the versions of server we're operating on, but it is the future. It's the Windows Administration Center web-enabled tool that lets you administer remote servers as long as you connect them in and add them to the console. And we'll use the Windows Admin Center to show you how to reach out and do the same exact thing on one or more connected servers. So we'll show you three different ways to add a user. Let's begin by jumping in. We'll load up and open up our server manager on the local server, and then we'll use it to access the computer management tool from the tools menu. Now, if you're like me when you administer servers, what I often do is I bring server manager up when I need it and do whatever I need, and then I will close it when I'm done. Number one, because I'm not sure when I'll come back to the server. If I do come back remotely versus locally, I may or may not need that tool. And if someone else is going to jump on and administer that server in between the times I am there, I want to leave a tidy workspace for them. So if you come to the server and server manager's closed and you've often scratched your head and wonder, well, where'd it go and how do I get it back? Because it loads up automatically when you log on the first time. Well, all you have to do is come down here to the start menu and let's just zoom in so you could see this. And when I do that and click, I'm going to be able to search for it. It's actually right there in the list alphabetically under S, but depending on the number of programs you have installed, it may or may not show up and easily be seen right there, but it's going to be pinned as a tile under the Windows Server area on the right. You can see upper left-hand corner on that tic-tac-toe board of tiles. We'll see our server manager, and I can click there to be able to open it up, and that's what I'm going to do. So let me just minimize, get out of the Zoom mode, bring that up. And although we're not going to load it up right now, we'll bring it up towards the end of the demonstration. But if you do want to go ahead and load up the Windows Admin Center, you could certainly Google and go out and find that download link from the Windows Download Center to get the Windows Admin Center. But if you're interested, Microsoft gives you a nice little prompt here, and you can just follow that to be able to find out about it. So I'm just going to get rid of that, but we know we can download from there. We're on this machine, we're in the server manager on the landing page for the dashboard. We're gonna go over to the right-hand side. We're gonna bring up our tools menu, and I'm gonna go down, I'm gonna choose computer management. Second tool, it's alphabetical. And when I bring up the computer management tool, I'm just gonna minimize the server manager while we're at it. We're gonna be able to come over here, and we're gonna be able to see fourth item down as we go down, our local users and groups area will open it up. We'll see two folders. We're going to be interested in the users folder, and we'll be able to use this, highlighting it, to see what users are currently available on the system to create and add one or more brand new users. Now, you may have some default users built in. I do, and you will probably have a list that looks very similar. You may have additional accounts depending on the server. but you'll typically have an administrator, default account, and guest account, the default account, guest account, and whatever additional service accounts like the WDAG utility account are going to be disabled. They have a little arrow on the right-hand side pointing down in a circle that indicates they're currently disabled, but you will see they are there. No additional accounts have been created. No problem. We can add one very easily. Right-click on the users folder, and when we do that, you'll see we get a new user option. Now, I can do that right from here, or I can move over to the white space anywhere underneath the existing users right here. Right-click at the same menu option. And when I do that, I get a little form that I have to fill out. Ask for some very simple stuff. Username, full name, description, password, confirm the password, keeping in mind whatever password policy requirements in terms of length and complexity we may have, and then some options about how we want the user account to initially be configured. So I'm going to go ahead and add this user in. I'm going to call this user the Adam2 user. We'll just go ahead and do that. We'll put a description in. Let's call this, or say this will be Hello World. And then I'm going to put in a password meeting whatever complexity requirements I may have specified. So let me just type that in real quick. I'm going to uncheck the box about forcing the user to change their password at the next logon. We're not going to worry about that. Assuming I type the passwords correctly and they match, user is created. Now you'll notice the user doesn't show up back here yet, even though the user has been created. As soon as I click close, user account pops right in. It's there. We just don't see it till the tool closes. And then I can see, sure enough, my user account has been created and we are good. So let's put a check in that first of three methods to do this via the GUI, the graphical user interface, using the computer management tool, and we are successful. We're going to minimize that tool, leave it open. So we're going to use it to verify how we create our user using PowerShell. But let's go over here. I've loaded up PowerShell. Now I've got a few versions of PowerShell on this machine. Got the most recent version, PowerShell 7, what we commonly call PowerShell Core. I've got the older version of PowerShell that's built in. This is PowerShell 5 that's in the system natively, the command line version. And then I've got PowerShell Ice, the graphical editor for PowerShell, which I'm going to use running as administrator just because I have staged the script code that I want to use with you and show it to you so I can just have it nice and big on the screen. Don't have to worry about typing it. And so we're going to look at it there, and we just simply execute it right from there. It's all the same, regardless of the version of PowerShell I use. The commandlets are supported, and they will work the same way. Now, having said that, if you want to run PowerShell as an administrator on any of these versions, right-click, and under the More option, you will see there is a flyout menu that lets you run as administrator. I've done that for PowerShell Ice. I already have it open. And sure enough, you can see up here at the upper left, running as administrator, giving me the administrative control I need to execute commandlets and make sure I have the permissions necessary to do these tasks. Now we're going to start in item number one. You see I've commented out each of the script lines we're going to run. Create a user, but without a password. This may or may not be important to you on a local server, but it's good to know you can create a user without a password if necessary. It's a matter of using the right command and, of course, the right parameters. In line number three, new local user is the command. Name parameter specifies the name of the user. We'll iterate through in sequence, so we'll do Adam number three. Description parameter, whatever's inside the quotes, including spaces and punctuation, will be reproduced, so I can either keep what's there or modify that. But then the no password parameter at the end of the line is going to force the creation of the user without a password. Let's take a look. Just highlight this. Now in ICE, I can just go ahead and highlight the line. If I only want to execute one line, I can hit F8 and or I can press that button right up there, which is going to let me execute the code. So I'm going to do that. And when we look, do that, watch down here, and we will see that sure enough, the user is created. You can see right down here, Adam3, name, enabled status is true, meaning yes, the user was created, enabled, and was, or is, I should say, available, and whatever the description is. Now, I could check the status of the user right from here by using a get local, and we like PowerShell Ice because it has the auto sense and auto tab complete function, so I actually get the graphical prompt for whatever commands that I want to potentially use. I'm going to use get local user. That's going to allow me to be able to see a list of all the users on the machine. And sure enough, there is Adam3 right there, if I can highlight. And that is the user we just created. Now, if I go back to the computer management tool, and I just click away and come back to be able to refresh the screen, and you have to refresh. It's just the way the tool is. You'll notice that the Atom 3 user was indeed created. And if we take a look, we can see that indeed user must change password next logon is set because we created the user without a password. So we have been able to do that in PowerShell. And before we put a check in our second method, I have a couple other things that may be of interest to you. So we'll quickly point them out, but let's call this one basically done as well. Now I added some additional code here that may be of interest to you. What if you want to create a user with a password? Well, we could do this a couple of ways. I could type the password in as I create the user, but that's not really secure. It's not going to store the password in a way that somebody looking over my shoulder cannot see it. And if anybody gets a hold of it or gets a hold of the script, if I save it and make it available, well, then they know the password for the user. That's not really a good idea. But I can store the password in a variable, store it securely as a secure string so it's not available to anybody. Even if they bring up the variable, the $password statement creates a variable called password and sets it equal in line 7 to whatever the output of the prompt I'm about to create on the screen with the read host commandlet will be. I'll type in a password, it will be stored, but as a secure string. And then I'm gonna, in line 9, do the same thing I just did, new local user, username, but now I'm gonna specify the password parameter instead of no password, and I'm gonna use the value of the variable $password stored as a secure string to pass the password through and create it for the user, but never expose it, so it's never gonna be seen. And then I use the full name parameter and the description just so that I can round out the user account creation as you see. So let's create this password. Let me do this. Now this is going to prompt me on the screen. There'll be a dialog box shows up, small rectangular box right in the middle. And I'm going to have to type the password in. So watch for that. I'm going to hit F8. We see right there. Let's just zoom in so you could see that. I'm going to type the password in there. Hit OK. It's going to get stored as a secure string. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do this. And notice, you cannot see the password. You don't know what it is. I'm typing it, it's just got dots there so you can't tell. And if I'm not sure, just try again before I hit OK, right? So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. I'm gonna set that password, I'm gonna click OK, and it is now stored as a secure string. So now, just scroll down so we can see that. If I was to do this, you'll see, I can't see what the password is, I just get the information that is associated with the variable, but that indicator tells me the password is stored securely and I'm not gonna be able to see what it is, but the system can use it, as we're about to see in line number 9. All right, so now I'm gonna create a user called Atom4. We're just gonna iterate through there, gonna highlight that, gonna hit that. Sure enough, what do we get? Atom4 is created, enabled true. If we do this, we can see that Atom4 right there was created. And if we do this, and we go here, and we do that, and we come back, whoops, let's refresh one more time. And sure enough, we could see Atom4 was indeed created. So we now have created a user with and without a password using PowerShell. If I want to add a user to a group, little extra bonus for you, you could do that with the add local group member commandlet. You can tell there based on the group parameter and the name, I would add the Atom4 user into the administrator's group. And if I want to remove a user, just simply use the remove local user commandlet, and I can easily remove the user from the system as well. All right, I'm going to call PowerShell done, and we've done our second of three ways, or demonstrated our second of three ways, that we can add a user to a local server. Now the third way is going to be using the Windows Administration Center, or Windows Admin Center. It's a web-based tool I've already installed and configured. I'm going to bring it up in Microsoft Edge. And I have shortcut, I've just bookmarked the shortcut for it there because I don't want to remember the URL. So I'm just going to click to bring it up. You'll see it's going to load up. Give it just a second. Windows Admin Center. Now this is used to administer remotely, meaning I can connect to servers that are anywhere, provided I can get to them through firewalls and make sure that they're available with a public IP address, all the stuff we would have to do, and I can add them in. Now, and I've got permission, of course, to do that. Now I'm cheating a little bit. I've installed the Windows Admin Center on the same server I'm about to administer just for ease of demonstration purposes, but I can easily be running this from anywhere as long as I add the server, and I could do that using the add feature right here, very simple to do, but I've already added it. So I'm gonna just simply click on the link that represents it. That is the gateway that connects me to the server. And when I do that, it will connect, and I've got my administrative interface. We give it just a minute to touch the machine, connect to it, make sure it is communicating. I can see the general information about it. I could see all the stuff. I'm using Windows Server 2019 Data Center Edition. I could see the size of the system, the hard drive, the memory, et cetera. It knows that I am running it as a virtual machine. It's very smart. And I can restart, shut down, do all sorts of stuff from here, which is good to know, but we're not going to spend time on right now. And I've got a bunch of different tools available to me to administer. Now, we want to add a user. So let's scroll down. And sure enough, I actually have two options to do that, by the way, from here. I can use PowerShell right from here, connect to the system remotely as an administrator, and do what I just did in PowerShell right from within the Windows Admin Center. It's actually pretty cool. I also can come down here and, whoops, I went too far. Let me go back up there. And I can use the local user and group item, which is the equivalent of the computer management tool, and then just highlighting and finding that tool. I could do it right from here, and it's going to look and feel the same. The only difference is I'm doing it directly on or from this remote interface. And we've already been through this. You know what to do here. We go, we click new user. We're going to simply fill in the form. You can see over here, name, full name, description, password, confirm password, and then submit. All right, looks like we're up to Adam 4. So let's do Adam 5. We'll do that. And we'll do Adam 5, except we'll type that in correctly. We'll do description and then our password. So let's put in our password. It gives me the information about whether the password is meeting those complexity requirements or not. That's what that red text was. We want to see the password, make sure I typed it correctly. Click there to see it. I'm going to confirm it. Do that. Looks like the passwords will match. We click submit. Sure enough, don't want to save that password. Password is good. User has been added successfully. We see that. And we can see the user indeed has been added successfully. There we go right there. And we can see that if I click through, highlight, I can manage the user, put it in a different group like we would have done from PowerShell. I could delete it like we would have done from PowerShell. And you'll notice I can change their password or edit the user properties right from here, like I could have done from PowerShell or would do on the local machine directly from the computer management tool. So these are the three different ways we can go ahead and add a user into a standalone server, whether it's running Server 2016, 2019, or 2022. All three mechanisms will work. All three tools are installable, configurable, and usable, or are already present in the system, in other words, and all three operating systems will have the same exact experience for you as an administrator and as an end user. I am going to be back with additional ways you can streamline, speed up, optimize your administration of Windows Server, regardless of the operating system you're running. But until I come back with more episodes, I'm going to wish you happy server administering and remind you, you can always check us out over at IT Pro TV for lots of additional training, tips, and techniques, not only on Windows Server administration, but across all of the different platforms you use, whether it's Cisco, whether it's VMware, whether it's Microsoft Azure, Google Cloud, and or anything else, on premises or anywhere. We've got training for it. We're going to tell you how to do it, and you can always hang out with us to find out more. I'll see you soon.